I think some of the best experiences that I've had are when patients have told me they came to clinic and they didn't realize how bad they felt, and then they started on treatment and they realized how much better life could be. Sickle cell disease is a problem with hemoglobin. What happens is the red blood cells are normally shaped, I call them a jelly donut, and they become more banana shaped. And so they don't flow through blood vessels like they should. And they also break down more easily than a normal blood cell. I think when I looked at what patients with sickle cell disease really need is that our treatment options are really limited. We don't know enough. And the best way to do that and to do that systematically is to do it with research. Most kids will survive into adulthood, but the life expectancy is really only into the mid-40s to mid-50s, which really hasn't changed much in the last 30 years. One of the great things that we have here is we're really trying to improve their quality of life and their outcomes as they become adults, because that's where we have the biggest gains to make. That kind of balance between inpatient and outpatient and preventative and treatment therapies for sickle cell disease, I think, is an important balance to strike. I have not heard or been to an institution that actually has more people focused in sickle cell disease and has been dedicated to helping children and families with our coping with it. I think that's one of the best parts of my job, is because we get to see kids and see parents, and we get to know them so well throughout their entire lifetime and let them challenge us.